remember what I've told you so many times. I'd rather sail and hit a log than have it sail. He rotted in dry dock.
Tuesday, November 2nd, 1982, at 10 a.m., the 50-year preaching ministry of Brother Lester Roloff came to a close. The news of his death quickly spread across the nation. 3 days later, more than 7,000 people gathered to pay their last respects to a great man of God. For more than 2 hours, leading fundamentalists from across the country came and spoke of the great impact Brother Roloff had had upon their lives and ministries. Speaking for all of the preachers that were not on the platform was Brother Jack Hiles. He likened the death of Brother Roloff to a runner finishing the first part of a relay race.
Someone has the baton. He holds the baton in his hand. He runs the track one time. He comes back and he gives the baton to somebody else. Now the only hope the first runner has to win a gold medal is resting in the second, third, and fourth runner. And so when the first runner finishes his race, it matters not how well he ran. Unless those who run after him succeed, then his race cannot be made perfect. So we hold in our hands the rewards, eternal rewards, of Lester Roloff.
With the passing of the baton, the responsibility is greater upon us than ever before to continue these ministries. Brother Roloff's body was laid to rest directly across the road from the People's Baptist Church in Memory Garden Cemetery.
The Lord will not shake upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen.
Many of you have asked, what's happened to the ministries of Brother Lester Roloff in Corpus Christi, Texas? As you can see, we're going full steam ahead. Our 5 homes are filled. Our telephones ring constantly. Our work has not changed. The spirit and philosophy that guided Brother Roloff in his daily decisions has set the course for us to follow. More than 30 years ago, Brother Roloff incorporated Roloff Evangelistic Enterprises. He named his vice president a close friend. This man, who has remained vice president through these years, is now president, Mr. Alfred Edge.
Now, Brother Roloff, as founder and president of the Roloff Evangelistic Enterprises, operated these ministries similar to how a chairman of the board or president of a corporation would operate a company. And as president, he did most of the planning and decision-making. He surrounded himself with a very capable staff of superintendents for the various homes and works. Now these ministries are under the direction of the board of directors, myself and 2 others from the Corpus Christi area, plus 3 other directors from various locations in the United States. At the time of Brother Roloff's death, I believe there was approximately 500 boys, girls, men and women in the homes for help. I'm happy to report there's been no reduction in this number. Also, the radio ministry, known as the Family Altar Program, is still nationwide, broadcasting over 150 or more stations. You ask what our goals are for the enterprise? It is our desire to be debt-free in 1983 and to expand these ministries as financial support permits. Calls at the rate of 30 to 50 per day are still coming in from the parents, pastors, probation officers, and others asking for admission for some boy, girl, or woman who is in desperate need for spiritual help. Isn't it a shame we do not have the financial support to provide a place for those who need to come to these homes? Also, many other requests for the family altar program to be put on other stations. Won't you pray with us about these needs? I want to personally thank you and all the many friends who have supported these ministries and ask you to continue this support. These ministries operate only by your voluntary contributions, as we do not accept any state or federal monies.
We're now at our main office on Park Avenue in downtown Corpus Christi. Your mail is received, read, and answered in this office. This office is managed by a very dedicated and talented lady, Brother Roloff's personal secretary for many years, Miss Ida Kavick.
I want to thank you who pray for us and who are faithful to help us in the support of the work here. Do you know what the last two words recorded by Brother Roloff were? When he realized that he was facing the storm, he asked clearance from the flight center to go to a higher altitude. They checked and they told him to go ahead. Brother Roloff didn't say, Roger. He didn't say, 10-4. He said, thank you. You know, I believe if Brother Roloff had been given an opportunity to say any last words, he would like to have said to all of you and to all of his friends, and especially to the preachers, thank you for helping me to do what the Lord called me to do. And when we all get home, we will share and share alike. As you know, Brother Roloff had a deep and abiding love for others, which is evident in the message that we would like to share with you now.
What I'm saying tonight is that God loves little girls and little boys and men and women. Fact is, everything I find in this Bible has to do with the love of God. Everything God's ever done, He has done in love, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Did you know that love is the first fruit of the Holy Spirit? Did you know that love is the first mark of a Christian? Did you know that love is God Himself, because the Bible says God is love. Did you know that it's the outstanding, distinguishing fact of a man's salvation? The first commandment, thou shalt love. The second commandment, thou shalt love. On these two hang all the law and the prophets. Did you realize that the love of Christ is the law of Christ? Why, He said, bear you one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ.
Here at the home Brother Roloff founded, we're continuing to follow those Bible guidelines with love for boys and girls, men and women, for finding the way to restore their lives through the love of Jesus Christ. I'm Wiley Cameron, pastor of the People's Baptist Church here in Corpus Christi, Texas. The church and its dedicated workers are the nerve center of all of our work. It is also my responsibility to direct the operation of all the homes. The Lighthouse for young men 18 to 25, many are here by court order. The City of Refuge for older men. Our Anchor Home for Boys, also many are court ordered here. The Peaceful Valley Home, the Jubilee Home for Women, and the Rebecca Home for Girls. I could not help but think of all of these young people when a woman newspaper reporter called me right after the death of Brother Roloff and asked if I thought judgment would fall upon America. My answer was, lady, God's judgment has already fallen on America, with over 6 million young people on the streets of America, 150,000 of which disappear into the flesh markets of our depraved society. Along with this has come the epidemics of venereal herpes and AIDS, and now an outbreak of leprosy. Along with the collapse of all moral restraint has come the sabotage of the American home by the media, the ridicule of traditional values by our Puritan forefathers have been made a laughing stock. The patriarchs of our republic have been reduced to mental retards by the modern textbook writers, and our once proud patriots are now considered right-wing extremists. However, these are only symptoms of a much deeper problem. Nations, as well as individuals, not only die by disease, but they die by suicide and by malpractice. The wrong doctor has been the cause of many deaths. I fear that America has been listening to the wrong doctor. Modern diagnosis has resulted in the dispensing of a fatal drug called religion. When God's people turned away from following him, his remedy was to send a preacher with, "Thus saith the Lord." He sent Moses to say, "Let my people go." He sent Nathan to remind David that kingly robes would never cover up adultery and murder. He sent Elijah that caused dew nor rain to fall upon the earth for the space of 3 years and 6 months. Amos, the plumb-lined preacher, called Israel to prepare to meet thy God. Let us pray that God will give us space to repent. We see the judgment of God every day when we turn away almost 50 people from our homes. Every home now has a waiting list. May God raise up those who will support these end-time ministries. Please pray for us once a day and write once a month. We invite you to come to Corpus Christi, Texas, and tour the homes. Tours are available daily. See for yourself God's miracles being worked before your eyes. Join us now for a closer look at these miracles.
The Anchor Home houses boys ages 9 through 17. It is our prayer that we can reach these young lives before they get involved in adult crime. If all the Lighthouse boys had to serve their full prison terms, it would add up to hundreds of years. The City of Refuge is our oldest home. Many years ago, Brother Roloff saw that wayward men needed more than a few nights in a rescue mission. Hundreds of men across our nation live for God today because of help they received at this home.
I was brought up in a Christian home with Bible discipline from my mother and father. But when I got to about the age of 16 years old, I got into a state of rebellion and just turned my back on God and everything that I was taught at home. I left home, went off to a military school, and got under, like Brother Paul said to the church at Colossae, got to the point of where I was listening to man and what the world had to offer, philosophy and vain deceit, after the rudiments of the world and not after Christ, because I didn't really know Christ in my heart. And I graduated from that military high school and went to college and flunked out, got into drugs and alcohol pretty heavy, and went off into the Navy. I stayed in there 4 years and was a heavy drinker in there. And towards the latter part of my fourth year in the Navy, I got married and stayed married for several years, but I still had the alcohol, drug problem. Everything that the world had to offer just didn't work out for me, and I knew I was lost, and I needed something more than that. And my mother and father never gave up on me. They prayed for me over the years, and as it turned out, I lost everything. I lost my family. I lost a good business that I had, and my father came to where I was living and brought me home with him. And between him and another man that knew something about the Roloff Enterprises out here, they were able to encourage me to come out here, and I praise the Lord that I did. I went into the City of Refuge home, and I got saved a short time after I came into the home, and I got into the Word of God and into prayer, and I just have been growing in the grace of God ever since, and I praise the Lord for my salvation and these homes out here. and what the Lord's doing out here for people in trouble. Thank you very much.
The Peaceful Valley Home in the Rio Grande Valley of South Texas is our home for retired Christians. Daily, these prayer warriors meet and pray for all our work. Our citrus groves produce more than 200 tons of fruit each year. This home is self-sustaining and is an asset to the ministries. The Jubilee Home is for ladies above school age. Many families have been reunited through the ministry of this home. Rebecca, our home for teenage girls.
Before I came into Rebecca, I lived a life of sin and defeat, and all I cared about was my drugs, my rock music, and I was already saved, and I knew that the Lord wanted me to turn away from the things that I did, but yet I still didn't, and I just got worse and worse, and I rebelled against my parents and left home, and finally the Lord brought me low enough where he ended me up in an emergency room, and then I came to realize that I really needed to go back to him and rededicate my life, but I still had a lot of pride, and my mom came and picked me up at the emergency room, and she said, Lord, she said, the next time we find you, we're afraid we're going to find you dead, and that really touched my heart, and I knew how much my parents loved me and how much they cared for me, and the next day, my mom told me I was going to Texas, and the only thing in Texas I knew was Corpus, and the only thing in Corpus was Rebecca. And so I came into Rebecca, and the Lord really started blessing my life. At first, it was hard, but then I just rededicated my life to him, and things have gone so smoothly. And I know there's sometimes there's trials and tribulations, but the Lord just gives me strength. And I know that he'll just bear me through them, and he'll just carry me through. And although my future may be unclear to me, but I know the Lord has everything planned out, and I just want to...
The heartbreaking stories of these girls go on and on. What they've received at Rebecca cannot be measured in dollars and cents. Nor can our love for those in serious trouble. We're grateful for the fine relationship we have with judges and probation officers across the nation. Here in Hidalgo County, Texas, which borders the Rio Grande with the country of Mexico, is the Honorable Judge Joe B. Evans.
I've had a unique opportunity of experiencing dealing with the Roloff Enterprises. For the last several years, I've had the opportunity, in lieu of sending individuals to the state penitentiary at Huntsville, as an alternative, placing those individuals with the Roloff system. I can truthfully say that the system has not cost the state of Texas one nickel. I can further verify that but for the Roloff program in Corpus Christi, the seven or more individuals that I have placed there would be presently in Huntsville, Texas Department of Correction, at a cost to the state of Texas of a minimum of $10,000 per individual per year. I've been impressed with the results, and more particularly with the two individuals who are physically present to verify those results. Robert Allen Plath, one of the young men here in the courtroom, was faced with an absolute commitment to the Huntsville for an armed robbery. I believe that Mr. Plath, through by virtue of the resources made available to him at Roloff, has turned to the only area in which a human being can correct their ways, to wit, to God. Additionally, Juan Salinas, who was a habitual forger here in Hidalgo County, was also headed to Huntsville. In lieu of Huntsville, this court accepted the recommendation of a gentleman by the name of Brother Graham, that who represented the Roloff Enterprise through this court, and through his efforts, the court accepted his recommendations and sent Mr. Salinas to the program. Again, in this court's personal opinion, unless we are able to find alternatives to the Texas Department of Corrections. One of these days, you and I are going to be working 50% of our time just to support a maximum security unit. In the state of Texas, there are in excess of 34,000 individuals in Huntsville, Texas. This session of the legislature, the head of the Texas Department of Corrections asked the state of Texas to appropriate $1.5 billion to operate the prison system, and the prison system in Texas is the most efficient operated system in the United States. Can you imagine taking from the state budget 10% to foot the bill for the cost of a penitentiary? Can you imagine what $1.5 billion would do if we were able to put it into the area for those who cannot care for themselves, the elderly, the sick? Think what could be done. Roloff Enterprise System that I've had contact with is an absolute alternative to Huntsville. Now, it will not work for everybody. It's only those individuals who truly believe in God and are willing to turn their life over to God that it will work. We're constantly confronted with individuals who come before this court and say, please send me to Roloff. No, that's not the criteria this court uses. This court uses the individuals connected with the association that can come in here and say, Judge, this individual is not pulling the wool over your eyes. This individual has truly confessed. This individual is truly willing to accept God. For those that I've sent so far, we've had one that failed out of approximately seven. It's indeed a pleasure for me to have at least been associated with Reverend Roloff. He, in fact, had just left McAllen when the terrible accident happened. I can highly recommend to judges all over this state, consider the alternatives. If the individual before you truly has turned to God, I believe the Roloff system and systems similar to that is the ideal solution as an alternative to the state penitentiary.
Hello, my name is Robert Platt. 1 year and 8 months ago, I stood in this courtroom on the charge of aggravated robbery. Judge Evans saw fit to send me to the lighthouse. Since I've been there, the Lord has saved me, and he's changed my desires and changed my life. The judge saw the change that the Lord did in my life, and he allowed me to plead guilty to a lesser charge of simple robbery, which is a probatable offense. He gave me 10 years probation, and I want to thank Judge Evans for letting me go to the lighthouse and for his kindness. I want to thank the Lord for saving my soul. And I want to thank Brother Roloff for being a man with a burden for people in trouble like me. And I want to thank the Lighthouse for taking an interest in me when I needed help.
I want to say that I'm very, very grateful to the Lord for saving Robert. I'm grateful to Judge Evans for seeing fit to send him there. And I'm grateful to the Lighthouse for taking him in and taking an interest in seeing that his life was changed. He is saved and he is a completely different person. And I'm very grateful to all of them and to the Lord.
Thank you, Johnny Salinas.
Go ahead.
11 months ago, I was here at the courthouse. I was court ordered by Brother Joe B. Evans to the Lighthouse. And ever since I've been down there, got saved, the Lord's been blessing me since I've been down there for 11 months. This is changing my life. I don't got the same desires that I used to have about doing wrong. All I do now is want to serve the Lord. And I thank Brother Roloff for the homes it was in.
Okay, I'd like to thank the Lord first and Judge Evans for helping Johnny, and also for Judge Evans to recommend him, for recommending Johnny to go to the Roloff program also. I think it's just a wonderful program.
You have just witnessed two young men whom you've heard speak from experience with the Roloff system. You just heard the mothers of those two young men. What a tragedy it would have been had we not experimented with the system. I'm grateful to God for giving the judicial system sometimes an opportunity for alternatives. Thank you.
The ministries Brother Roloff founded are indeed alive and well. As you can see, these ministries involve people. In fact, we work with people one-on-one 7 days a week. When they come to us, they are very desperate. You can have a part in these ministries. In fact, you must stand by us with your prayers and your support so we can continue. When writing us, write your letter to the Family Altar Program, Box 1177, Corpus Christi, Texas. The zip is 78403.